वेलकम व्यूअर्स, दिस इज़ द पार्ट थ्री ऑफ द वीडियो सीरीज़ लर्निंग हाउ टू लर्न एंड वी विल कंटिन्यू फ्रॉम वेयर आई लेफ्ट इन माई प्रीवियस वीडियो दैट वॉज चंक्स. एवरी इंटेंस लर्निंग सेशन ऑफ 25 मिनट्स ऑफ लर्निंग वी डिस्कस्ड इन पोमोडोरो टेक्निक, a timer based technique where there are no distractions while learning. So every intense session of learning, a short burst of learning, will give you a gift of a chunk, a knowledge chunk, which will have application of many types. The first thing is you'll understand something well. You'll also be able to identify the context, the surrounding in which that learning has taken place. So taking it further from chunks, one chunk is one piece of learning, and acquiring it gives you an expertise which further assists you as you try and acquire further chunks. So if you have done a learning successfully, then it makes you a better learner in the next round of learning. And this is the process how you acquire a big library of chunks. And all experts, people who can speak with confidence, who can address all situations, all problems, or most problems, most situations, all these experts, they are owners of, proprietors of a large library of chunks, which has been acquired slowly, painfully, meticulously over a long period of time. But the beauty of learning is that every chunk that you acquire assists you with further learning and makes the learning easier. So with time, learning becomes easier. So there is a incentive for continuing to learn every day on a regular basis. Now, we would like to get into another area today in this presentation, and that is the two modes of mind and two modes of learning. Modes as in style of learning. Our brain has two modes of functioning. One is called focused mode and one is called a diffused mode. Focused mode can be understood as attentive mode, and diffused mode is not so attentive and close to sleep, close to relaxed mode. So attentive mode and relaxed mode, these are the two modes of brain. We might believe that while learning, we must concentrate very hard and we should go on focusing till we understand it. But there is a roadblock. Sometimes we face a material, a learning material that we have never seen before, that we have no idea about. And this is when the brain gets totally perplexed, totally puzzled, confused. And since there is no previous chunk, no previous learning which we can associate with this new information, with this new knowledge, we are not able to understand it in one go, in one session. So in this video, we would like to highlight the importance of the relaxed mode of mind and its importance in learning. So if you are learning something totally new, chances are you would not understand it the first time. If you don't understand it, don't sweat it, don't fret it, don't worry about it. But then don't give up either. So what you should do after 25 minutes of focused learning, you fail to understand. So relax. Do whatever you can, recall, test. But I'm sure since you don't understand it very well, so recall and notes will not actually happen. And experts say that you should now allow your brain to relax. And when it is relaxed, the neurons, they become spaced apart. They become more like distant from each other. But connections can still form. And maybe this chunk of information, knowledge that you wish to acquire, but you're unable to acquire because it is very difficult, very new. So when you let go of it and allow your subconscious mind, your long-term memory to handle it, chances are some new connections will form that will give you an idea, an insight into what it could be. And then when you again reread it, probably your chances of understanding will improve. I gave you an example of that benzene structure and a chemistry scientist thinking of it in a dream. In the Coursera, there are two examples. One is of Thomas Alva Edison, and the other one, another great, I think, painter. His name, I find it hard to recall. Never mind. That is memory. So, both these gentlemen, they used a technique whenever they were faced with a problem or a topic or a piece of information that was intractable, that was impossible to understand with their present understanding, with their present learning. So one of them would hold ball bearings in his hands. That was Thomas Alva Edison. And the painter, I hope I can remember his name during this presentation. He used to hold a bunch of keys in his hands. And they would allow themselves to relax and permit themselves to, you know, sit, lie down on a couch and allow themselves to go to sleep. But just when they are about to go to sleep, the diffused mind, the unfocused mind is still working on the problem that has been assigned to it. And then suddenly some connections will form, some understanding will flash, and as that new connections are being formed, and when you are about to fall asleep, your hands will open, loosen up, the ball bearings will fall, the key will fall, it'll make a noise, the noise will wake you up, and this new connection which has been formed when you were in a diffused state of mind, when you were not very conscious, not very attentive, but a new connection did take place with some previous learning, with some previous chunk of learning, and then this noise will wake you up, and probably now when you go and again tackle that topic, that problem, this time maybe you'll be able to handle it and understand it. So I would like to once again recapitulate this understanding, focused mode of learning and diffuse mode of learning. When we are in a focused mode, we are using the memory, the knowledge which is known to us, very well known to us. But if we come across something, a problem or a challenge or a topic or a chapter which is totally unknown to us, which is completely new to us, we find it very hard to understand, and then we should not keep on banging our head against the wall, keep on trying to figure it out. Maybe you'll not understand it in the focused mode, and you have to permit yourself to go into a diffused mode, relaxed mode of learning. And then the brain, subconscious brain, which is a vast storehouse of previous learning, previous experiences, some new connections may form, some new flash of inspiration may actually come, and that will assist you in learning this new topic better. This we can take further, and we can appreciate the value of sleep, sleep in learning. Learning is stressful, we have discussed it. Life is stressful, everyday life is stressful. There are so many demands on us, there are so many responsibilities on us. There are so many negative feelings we experience every day. So these stresses and experiences which are unpleasant, they create chemicals in the brain which the experts in Coursera, learning how to learn, they call it metabolites. I would like to use another term for it, toxins. I hope I'm correct, I'm not wrong. So these metabolites and these toxins which are released as a result of stress, they cloud our thinking. They make learning difficult to accomplish. And therefore, sleeping is a must so that the brain can go back to a relaxed mode. When we relax, I've already discussed, the neurons are spaced apart, there is gap, and the brain secretes some fluids which does internal housekeeping and sweeps away all these metabolites and toxins that are formed as a result of the stressful and unpleasant experiences over the entire day that has just gone by. So sleeping is as important as learning. And as we are talking about the brain and its capacity to learn, scientists have discovered that even after maturity, there are certain parts of the brain where new cells keep on regenerating. And this regeneration of cells means that brain stays young, brain stays healthy, and brain stays powerful. So apart from sleeping, there are other techniques, other ideas which help in this regeneration of cells. The first technique is exercise. Exercise improves brain functioning and improves generation of new brain cells, and you must exercise on a regular basis, especially jogging. Second thing is traveling. Traveling allows your brain to experience new things, and that also assists in regeneration of brains. They do not talk about it in that program, Learning How to Learn on Coursera, but diet and water is also crucial. There is a belief that we become what we eat. So eating healthy diet and drinking plenty of water also assists our brain to function at its optimum, at its best. So these are some of my learnings from Learning How to Learn regarding brain functioning. And this is the part 3 of the video. I hope I was able to contribute something into your learning. If you have any questions, please ask in the comments. Thank you very much for watching this video till this far. Thank you for your patience. Thank you for your interest. And thank you for learning how to learn. Have a great, great day ahead.